everybody. I'm Karen. This is Karen Puzzles. And today I am so excited to talk about a brand new jigsaw puzzle company that I'm so excited about. They are called Better Co. I just showed this puzzle and that puzzle in my haul video the other week, and the puzzles are just gorgeous. I have now had a chance to actually do the puzzles, so I'm gonna take you through all of the details, my full review. Let's get into it. So they have three puzzles that are out right now. This gradient puzzle, which is the one that I'm going to be talking about today. There's also the modern art puzzle, and then there's the third galaxy puzzle, which I have not gotten my hands on yet. Also, just for full disclosure, I was sent these two puzzles for free, but my opinions are entirely my own. And you guys know how much I love a good gradient puzzle, so let's take a look. First, I want to talk about the box, which is beautiful. It's so well designed, so modern, just like the AreaWare gradient puzzles. This is the type of box that you could just have out on display and it becomes a part of your home decor. I really like their logo, and the box is made of beautiful, thick cardboard, so it feels really high quality. However, I will say that the trade-off to having such a minimalist box is that you do lose some of the information that other puzzle boxes will tell you. Mostly the size of the finished puzzle, which it doesn't say anywhere on the box or on the website, so I went ahead and measured it for you. It is 50 by 70 centimeters, which is about, hang on, I wrote it down, 27 and a half by 20 inches. I actually emailed Vin, who's the guy that runs this company and makes these puzzles, and I mentioned that to him, and he told me that he is aware that he forgot to put that on this run of the puzzles. So in future runs of the puzzles, that information will be somewhere on the box. So the back of the box is completely blank besides the barcode, and it might have been more expensive to print on the back of the box, I don't know, but I feel like that's a little bit of a missed opportunity to share information like the size of the puzzle, the actual piece size, maybe the story of the company since they are a new company. And it would have been an opportunity to have the entire puzzle design on one flat surface, since the way the box is designed now, it wraps around to the sides, which is fine for this puzzle, but on the modern art puzzle, I found it kind of annoying to have to keep turning the box to see what the edges were going to look like. So let's open up the box. The first thing is this little flyer with a discount code to get more of their puzzles, which I might have to use to get the galaxy puzzle. Vin, the guy that I mentioned earlier who started this whole company, has a little blurb about himself and a direct contact email, which I think is such a nice touch for a new company. I've been emailing with him a little bit and he's been super responsive to all of my ideas and like critiques of the puzzles. So if you guys have any thoughts that I'm not covering here, make sure that you send him an email. I'm sure he'd love to hear from you. So besides that, there is a sealed bag with the puzzle pieces, and that is everything that's in the box. So let's take a look at the pieces. They're beautifully vibrant, really good quality. The cardboard is pretty standard, you know, not super thick, but also not really thin. They're a little glossy, but not so much that you have a ton of glare on them. But come here, come really close. I've got a little secret for you. As I was looking at the pieces, I thought that they felt a little familiar, and I realized that I'm pretty sure the company that manufactures this puzzle is the same company that makes the 1000 Colors puzzle. Not just because they're both gradient puzzles, but I grabbed a piece from each puzzle to compare them, and literally the finish is the same, the cardboard is the same. I couldn't even tell them apart between the two puzzles without looking back at where I took the piece from and seeing like which one fit there. So I'm pretty sure that whoever makes these puzzles is the same company that Vin got to manufacture his puzzles. Which, do not get the wrong idea, I'm not saying that this is a bad thing or that anyone like copied one another. The designs between the two puzzles, even though they're both gradients, the designs are very different. And since the 1000 Colors puzzles are so expensive to get here in America, since they're manufactured, since they're sold all the way from Australia, I'm pretty sure they're all manufactured in China. But these are super expensive, as I talked about in my video all about these puzzles. So here's a little secret, which you'll only know if you watch Karen Puzzles. If you get the Better Co. puzzles, it's basically, you know, the exact same puzzle on the inside, just with a different design. So here's a little secret for you. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started on the gradient puzzle. Of course, I had to sort the pieces by color, since that's basically the only way to approach a puzzle like this. However, one more nitpick about this puzzle. There is quite a lot of puzzle dust. Some of the most puzzle dust in any puzzle I can remember doing lately. This doesn't really bother me, but I know that some of you have commented in the past that it bothers you, so now you know. So when it came time to put the puzzle together, one thing that I really appreciate is how unique all of the piece shapes are. I talked about this in the 1000 Colors puzzle review as well, where in a puzzle where the color is the only thing you have to go on, it makes it so much easier and so much less frustrating if the piece shapes are super unique. So you're not just trying piece after piece that basically look identical. The border and center of this puzzle actually went together super quickly. It only took me 11 minutes to do the border, and then another hour to get to this point where we've basically divided it into half a pink puzzle and then half a blue puzzle. The pink side was definitely the hardest part of this puzzle. It's the largest section that's basically all one color, so I ended up having to sort the pieces by shape, and it took me an hour and 40 minutes to do the pink side. The blue side was definitely easier since there's more variation in the colors on that side, so it only took me an hour to finish the blue side. And that all adds up to just under 4 hours of actual puzzling time putting this one together. So overall, I really enjoyed this puzzle. It's an interesting take on the idea of a gradient puzzle, since it's not an even gradient all the way across, like all of the other gradients I've done. Just like the Ravensburger Crypt puzzle, I think I would have enjoyed it more if I had worked on it more slowly over the course of a few days. Doing the whole thing at once, especially the pink section, was kind of exhausting. But if you look at it almost as three separate puzzles, the center, the pink, and the blue, it is totally doable over the course of a few days. So I always like to show whether the pieces lock together, and they definitely do. Not so tightly that you can pick the entire thing up, but if you have a section put together, you can definitely move it around without it crumbling apart. And the other thing that I talk about sometimes is how I don't glue my puzzles together, because a fun puzzle doesn't always translate to a picture that I want to hang on my wall. But I think any of the Better Co. puzzles would look beautiful on your wall if you did want to glue them together, and it would be really fun to style a room around one of these puzzle designs. Also, just to quickly talk about the Modern Art puzzle, I didn't film this one, but I did put together this time lapse. I loved this puzzle so much, probably more than the gradient one, actually. It was the perfect difficulty where it was challenging, but not frustratingly difficult. The texture of the paint is really fun to look at, and you can see that there are big sections of the different colors, so I never felt stuck or like I wasn't moving forward. This one took me probably about a little over 5 hours, so actually more than the gradient puzzle, but I just love this image. I'll definitely be returning to it. I had so much fun with this one. So if you want to get these puzzles for yourself, They're super easy to get your hands on, at least here in America. They are on Amazon Prime for $20 each. But don't forget about that promo code that comes in the box so that you can save a little money if you do decide to get them. I'm gonna link these right down below with my Amazon affiliates link. So if you do buy them, please use that link. It would really help me out. As far as I can tell, these are only on Amazon for now. They're not being sold on or at any like brick and mortar stores or on any other websites, but I'm sure that's gonna change as the company grows and expands. So I would love to know from you, what do you think? Have you ever done one of these puzzles? Which of the three puzzles that they've released so far would you be most likely to want to do? Don't forget to like this video and subscribe for new puzzle videos almost every week. You know, I do other stuff too. This isn't my only job. Sometimes I have to skip a week, but I try. And your code word, if you watch the entire thing, is going to be modern. Okay, I'm gonna go. I've got more puzzles to do and more videos to film. So happy puzzling. I'll see you all next time.